wave your hands to Jesus if you know who you are, gentlemen.
Yeah, I'm a lot of energy with that song.
I love that song. It's so amazing. I just love what the message in it. I know who I am.
Hallelujah.
On a Friday morning, that's awesome.
I'm walking in power, walking in miracles. I know whose I am.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody, right, somebody. DJ Genius.
This girl has hidden talent, singing, dancing, and preaching.
Yes, Steve. Yeah. You know, when I play that song, Yanni, when he came in the morning today, it was like, now I'm chill. I would have played the song. I sparked something, Yanni.
Sparked something.
Pandambegu.
Pandambegu.
She came
out. Walks like a child. How have you guys been?
Awesome.
What have you been up to?
Awesome week. Awesome. Working, of course.
You look and, suspicious.
Working and having party. So you know, that song.
Yeah.
Lifts my heart also.
No, it doesn't. You were saying that you watched about Kanyari.
I say that song brings life to, you know, to see.
Yeah.
Oh, it's rainy season. It's a very powerful, beautiful song. So I guess last weekend we had a team building.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, I went to your county.
Somewhere down
Manzoni. It was beautiful. We had such a good time.
Mm-hmm. Who is we?
The team.
No, you're confusing people. Like,
Sorry, thinking, team building, KTN.
Where was I?
Yeah.
No, y'all, like the editorial part of KTN.
We missed that one.
Yes, of course.
No,
to editorial on a bond. No,
we're missing a lot of hanging
out. So it was really so much fun.
Yeah.
So exciting. Played fun games, stuff to really team build. Came up with an anthem. Mm-hmm. Really beautiful.
You have some photos to show for that?
Yeah. I'm gonna show you.
Swimming guys.
Some guys swam. I know Biwot was went swimming. Mohammed Mahmoud swam as well. We danced in the evening. Great music. It was so fantastic.
You look a bit suspect in that one. Like last weekend, what did I do?
Look suspect?
You look like you want to talk more about that, and after the cameras are.
Like
no,
you
can say much more time.
And all that. Awesome. But last weekend was full of activity and. And I can't remember much, man. It's been a crazy week. So much happening.
What event did you attend?
Last weekend, there was a Meru something.
The Meru Night.
Meru Night, alongside
Meru
Thika
Night.
Road.
Yes. Somewhere on Thika Road.
Somewhere Thika Road.
Yeah.
And many other activities going on last
week. Meruans are coming together now. Yeah. You know, they've been accused for so long for not producing artists.
Meru guys can sing. They can sing and they can also
sing
dance.
Their songs, not people's
their
songs. So they're trying.
Yeah. And they can pick somebody's beat. Like Genius can create them a beat. And Meru's.
I like your pendant thingy.
It's the other thing in town now. This is the Extreme Award. Come in December.
No, I'm not talking about your jersey. I'm talking about,
The old core thing. This is part of it, and this is the Extreme Awards coming in December. Mm-hmm. Young people, music, every sort of talent among young people is.
They tweeted us that we were nominated. Is that how they communicate nomination?
You will get more communication, I think, but this is communication already that this is really happening.
Yeah, because I saw a tweet from so somebody tweeted me from this Extreme Awards and said, oh, Morning Express has been nominated. I'm like, it's hard to believe that because, surely that is not how to communicate.
We are. And then
are you behind the awards?
No, not really. I just got a top.
But I like the jersey.
It's a beautiful top.
I like
many guys in town now have these tops. They're available for guys to grab. And I think they're going to be visiting.
So let's get into the pulse and we'll talk about a few of the other stories that have been breaking the internet, if you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah. Yes. I like what you say, breaking the internet.
What has been breaking the internet the past few days? If you don't know what I'm talking about, you will.
Yeah.
We'll share with you about that. But the hair model, she looks good.
She looks good. One Waithera.
Yeah.
23-year-old young girl who says she likes reading, cooking, and traveling.
Yeah.
And page two, there it is. Again, details about the girl. And for those guys who want to be a cover and all that, they have the details of where to go, who to contact, and such thing. And I like the past vibe, page two. Another little thing about the she-man, the guy who behaves like the lady. And a little vibe there just to start people's heart. And
so a guy who behaves like a lady?
Yes.
Okay.
Is it like those Mandela Onome guys?
We don't want to say. Speaking of the Mandela, you know, he'd announced this strike.
Yes, yes, on 11th of November.
You talked about
it. Yeah, did you guys do it? Now, yeah. you guys were not too.
We're on record on the show that there was no way I was about to abandon.
Yeah, participating. Well, sister, no, I'm talking about now. No, not about your sisters and all. No, your woman.
Yes.
That you were to deny her those rights.
There's no way Kenyans would do that.
Most people
forgot.
Other people do not mark the calendars.
First, did you even know what it was about?
I'm abstaining.
Did you know why you were abstaining?
Yeah, you some sort of one day.
Told people to wave at their girlfriends and their wives. Don't shake their hands.
So you guys did not participate?
No,
you just
mean
there?
Most people forget. I'd really want to see who participated in that.
That guy was alone.
Okay, so let's go back to the page, to the she man.
Yeah.
So there are men who behave like women. Mm-hmm. They're those who rush home for Mexico. Mexican soups.
Mm. Ah. Would you find that cool with your man?
Never. Actually, I sky up on old soap. I don't watch soap. How is he watching?
Is he
like, who the hell?
I like this one too. Too neat, too sissy.
Yeah.
Too neat is good. You know,
too neat.
You know, a man needs some. When a woman can judge.
Some roughness. Yeah, kajashu. No. How do you even say that?
He's not supposed to be this clean thing.
Take that back. Take Kajasho. No. He does not. He don't want Kajasho.
You just can't
like you say, Manaumeni Bidi. It's about a lot of energy and stuff. No, that's
it's not wrong.
Like that disgusting one. It's just because you've been trying to.
No, we don't even
effort.
Want you to have a little Kajasho. Yeah. Just, you know, sort yourself out.
You can't be too clean. It's too.
You
specific.
Need to be clean and neat. I want a man who's clean and neat.
And many others. Talking about this guy who likes gossip all the time.
Yes.
I mean, every time he's just like
so unmanly.
Yeah.
And many others. Good stuff there.
Okay, let's cross over to Caught Out, page 5. Mm-hmm. A lot was happening.
Yes.
And
mostly
saw
in Kisumu. The city.
Yes.
The Lake City.
Kisumu City.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And another talking point about Kogalo winning the trophy. And again,
you
saw a lot of action outside the pitch.
Yes, yes.
You know,
it was crazy.
Yeah, there was a picture I saw of some guys who were making out on top of a moving vehicle.
Yeah, but they defended themselves. They said they're just celebrating.
That's all they celebrate, they say.
That's dangerous. Yeah,
that's Kogalo celebrating on top of a car.
Moving car and they're making out.
They were moving on a moving car together. Yeah. And a lot of caught out from all of us. We have caught out from an event, many events that
they
were
look,
happening.
Something here looks like a car wash, bikini car wash event.
It's
we're on page
about.
5, yes. People.
Somebody who's lost.
Yes. So also, this is so sad, slip of the foot.
Yes.
Yes,
the
yes,
model
yes.
there. Oh, yes. No.
And it was captured all in all the through the lens of the car.
I know,
camera.
She walks.
Trust fuse for this.
Then she misses a step. Oh, then she goes down. Then she fully goes down.
This was a great event that was attended by the First Lady and the President. Mm-hmm. And their son, actually.
She fell in front of the president.
Yeah, she did.
She fell for them.
She fell for them. What event was this again?
It was a fashion awards thing that was happening in the Intercom. And this happened to her. This happens, I mean.
And it happens. Yeah. I've seen it happen.
It's unfortunate. Well, it does happen, but, you know, just
for
a comical look of it.
Just you just want to laugh.
I don't know. I want to laugh. But I found every time I watch on YouTube and I find models falling down, it's hilarious because of their face reaction. You know, they want to act like nothing happened.
that's the professional part of it.
Sometimes it's nice to appreciate. I fell down, guys, and I'm back up.
Well, you want her to fall and start crying?
Just clap and fell down. That's crazy.
Fully down is fully down.
No, kianguka umeanguka, but the cool thing as a model, get up and continue to stretch yourself.
Judging is going on, so don't lose it.
Don't lose it.
And a lot of cuts from everywhere. You can see that Mzungu guy, yes.
Eating chicken.
Jambuai chicken like this.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's now go to Wele Wele.
Yeah.
Hey, he's showing us a lot.
This guy did not show you a lot when he was here. He shows a lot.
Let's just say he was interesting. He was a good catch up.
I like that pose.
There's some things he said that were bordering on not TV content.
Yeah.
Yes, but it was fun to catch up with. It was lovely meeting him as well.
Maybe
yes.
What he never brought out on TV is what we captured today. Mkala has talked to him and he talks a lot of stuff.
Yes.
He goes ahead to talk about his baby mama and how they they're not interested with each other.
Yes.
Yeah, he did tell us he was dumped because he's short, though.
Well, he didn't say he was short. Oh, did he?
Oh, he said that here. Yeah, yeah, he said okay, he was dumped and because he's short.
It's all linked up. But
I love his honesty. Very few men will say that.
Who would say they got dumped because they're short?
Why would that happen, though? Why would you dump a man?
Because you want a taller man.
How do you even get started?
There are many aspects of being tall.
I just asked him if he's dating. He said, no, he was dumped. He said, oh, you were dumped. Why?
He said, because I'm short.
Because she said that I was too short.
The time you're making babies, were you taller or something?
Really?
I want to work with dumped when you were dumped. So
he's cool and he says he's moving on with life. So.
By the way,
but he's taking it very well.
It looks like he's free to open to speak about
When you're talking like that, you just know I'm doing cool and many. Many SMSs or messages are coming my way. So it's cool, Mama.
So you guys are happy you're not short, eh?
No.
The short man syndrome. Do you believe in that? That actually short men suffer from that?
No, it does exist. They're very many.
How short is short, though?
Short is short.
Yeah. And how tall is tall? You know. I was listening to these guys last night. They're talking about how you cannot... How ladies would try to wear... not to wear high heels because their men are not all that tall because you don't want to embarrass him in a way. It doesn't happen.
Classic example is Obama and Michelle. Mm-hmm. Michelle, just without any shoes, is very tall. Mm-hmm. You notice even when she wears her heels, they're super tiny, you know, this high. Mm-hmm. If she was, she put on skeletons. Mm-hmm. Skeletons. Skeletons. Did I just say skeletons?
You say that.
So if she put on stilettos, she'd be way taller than Obama. And this is the president, the leader of the most powerful country in the world. You do not want your wife taller than you.
That's wrong.
That already is in power play. I'm still trying to get a different picture.
The wife be taller than you is power play? I mean, is it?
Sweetheart, even handshakes, see, works this way. If I shake your hand and I do this, I am showing you that I'm in control.
Are you in charge? So I should keep it this way?
Yeah, this way.
Or in the middle.
Balance like this. Oh. You know? So it's all those things, height, it's a subtle things. Mm. They speak a lot.
Mm. Yeah.
That's why you find even presidents, when they're standing and taking pictures, they'll stand like this because they want to be at their tallest. You want to appear like the one edging everybody else out.
Yeah. I think they get intimidated because most tall chicks are lonely.
Oh. No, they're not. Yeah, no,
I'm tall. Hey, there's another tall even that one you just giraffes.
Oh, yeah, watch out, Shuguliki.
No, we love them all. We love
model tall.
Yeah, model tall.
Model tall.
Like a Juma. Lonely.
Most of the time like you're together, you're just in the car.
There are equally tall men.
If a Juma meets DJ Genius, he would not be interested in that number. That's
what do you think? By the way, sometimes it works very well. Yeah.
You know, like a short guy is a rocker.
Okay. Let's go to the cover story. Page 10 and 11. Tune in Tommy TV. What is this?
Tune into my TV.
Tune into my TV.
Well, it's what? Today we're on a roll.
Tommy.
Okay. Tommy, man. Tommy TV. Oh, it actually looks like Tommy.
No, it's a creative. You're right. I mean, it would sound like that.
It's like Tommy.
It's a creative guy, just did his thing, and so you're right. I mean,
by the way, it's Friday. My system is
tune into my TV is basically a story about the way young people are just
making internet stars. Yeah, you know? Nowadays, you know, you have a social media platform where you can advertise yourself. People are saying that the rules of TV are being redefined, they're being rewritten right now.
Yeah.
You know, because you can become famous on your own by creating your own channel, like on social media and YouTube and all the likes.
Yeah. So we thank God for TV as
Tommy
it is. Tommy TV.
That's a very nice name.
We thank God for KTN and Nation and everything that exists and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But we're just talking about guys who just go and film themselves on a subject that they want to talk about and post their videos in a very consistent way, either on YouTube or on whatever space they have it on the internet. And some of those guys are really making it big because sometimes when you post this, it's money generating.
Yes,
it is. And also it gets you to be seen as an expert, say in a field, especially on makeup, and you'll get contracts or whatever from that. So Tommy TV, power to that.
Tommy TV, you're part of that. And the crazy girl, Ella, the one you talked about, was supposed to be doing Big Brother has a very crazy one.
Yes.
Ella Inspire.
She's created her own channel called Ella Inspire.
Ella Inspire.
What does she talk about?
No, she's hosting a series of industry players like artists. on her show and just talking about not particularly artists.
I remember one particular video that she's done. It's called Tips Funga. It generated a lot of hits. She was talking about stuff like that. And the crazy bit about her, she feels nothing about what you may think about a TV station, because she even brings adverts and says, let's go for commercial breaks.
She can bring create imaginary adverts.
I like her attitude. That's a very good I was watching some of her
content last week, and I must say, well, she's
and you wait and watch this space. She'll get herself into some really good thing at the end if she keeps up. And
Sophia,
you know.
And that's how most of the music stars have been made now. Mm-hmm. You just post your thing there, and then DJ Genius would see it and say, exactly. Well, this guy is talented and exactly. that kind of a thing.
Exactly. Okay, then have you guys been to the movies recently? I haven't.
You haven't?
Neither have you.
Neither have I.
Okay, 15 minutes.
We are going on leave, so when we go on leave, we're
going to be watching. Yeah, we should like have a movie date.
So. True. But we keep...
are you going on leave as well, like we are?
I can create that.
You cannot create leave.
I can always create.
You cannot create leave. Either go on leave or my uncle.
Well, talking about why bad boys...
Why
are always good. Mm-hmm. Why
yeah, I'll let
why
you not read the headlines now, lest I read my own things. So the tag bad boys has been dragged through the mud many times, mm-hmm. but somehow these men still come out smelling like roses, do they? Mm-hmm. A bad boy lets a girl know she is not the only one, and only he can charm her into accepting the idea.
And that is what most chicks like.
Yeah, and this is the opposite of the guy page two.
Yes.
You know.
Yeah, the sissy.
Yeah, the sissy guy. The one who's going to do something on...
No, that was not even a sissy. That was just a...
This is a she-man.
That's just not... Yeah, the she-man.
Yeah, but now Angela here captures why bad boys are considered mysterious and darlings to many ladies. So do we have a couple of them?
Do you consider yourselves bad boys? Solo, do you think you're a bad boy?
Well, I don't think I can say for myself.
So you're a she-man?
No, I'm not a she-man.
It's something between those two. But away from the she-man, closer to the bad boy.
In the middle.
I think it's good to be a bit mystical in life as a man. I mean, when you open the old space for everybody just gets to think, that's your name, man. I'm okay.
Yeah. So you're saying Shafi is now girls like that?
He's a very mysterious guy, as many things as you can say.
He's a party animal.
Yes. He's a party animal.
That's not mystery.
That's a mystery.
He speaks things mystery? Out like...
Because you might not always find him in the party mood.
Oh, no, he's always in the party mood.
So he'll always leave you confused. What's happening?
You see, what is mysterious is this guy that's unpredictable, that I'm like intrigued by. I'm like, Lord, how
is
this?
What is
I look at them
What is unpredictable?
These ones, they're all very clear. I don't see.
She just refused to answer you about
that. Tell me what is unpredictable.
It's good to...
not unpredictable.
What is mysterious about a man?
You know...
It's a good story, let's
say. It's a good story, though.
Let's read more about the bad boys.
In the past, today.
Some very interesting points coming through. You know, those about what some of the characteristics of a bad boy, you know?
Like?
Something like...
She's just running away from it and she's telling guys to...
care so much about image.
So we want Paul to read the pulse.
And they say it like it is, you know? he's never much around, you know? Not obvious, like a guy who's always picking you up at 5 in the evening. Sometimes an azima simu.
That's not a bad boy. That's just a nasty, bad mannered man.
About that guy was always checking on his girl every minute, and then she has to get a hold in her.
Not all the time. That's a bit weird.
That's a she-man. That should be a cook or something.
Yeah, you can't.
Why is he concerned all the time if you are?
You can't check on me.
You have money in the pocket. Why? You should have it, right?
You should leave space to be missed. If you flood their space, then you become, you know, too much. Finally. Overhauled?
Mm-hmm.
Well,
DNG.
Yes.
We will tie the knot next year. So what was this ceremony? I saw these pictures. I thought it was the wedding.
Oh, yeah. Grasho, somewhere in Akabetelo.
It was Grasho.
Yes. Yeah, it was last weekend.
They've been dating for a while now?
Yes.
Quite a while. And
she's gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. She's quite gorgeous. Mm-hmm. Congrats, bro.
Yeah, congratulations, yeah. DNG.
And you know, he's been keeping her away from the media and the public eye.
Yeah.
But he says that's what she likes. And
that's what she likes.
You know, after the Grasho, they were asked, when do you expect them to... walk down the aisle, and he says definitely sometime next year.
Okay.
And a lot of men are going, by the way. A lot of men have been going there.
Going where?
Year. They've been taken.
Even women. Quite those men are going to themselves.
Have the girls been taken?
Those men were
Kenyan men are dealing with their sisters.
No.
Many women.
He's talking about the men going. Of course, if they're going, then the women are going in equal measure.
It's sad because
they're not marrying each other.
You know, the magnitude of the attraction for one man is quite big. So when one man disappears with one.
Yeah, the marriageable ones, the eligible ones, they're fewer.
Like
you're right.
Yeah.
So the space
not like
is not,
why are you not married if you're marriageable?
No, watch this.
You're also coming next year.
That's why when JG goes with this, Kenyan girls are now looking in Nigeria.
Yeah.
There's something about Nigeria. Is it in the Nairobi?
Yes, no, because
men are finished.
Yeah, we'll talk about
we're gonna discuss that one very.
Yeah, some.
And there goes the story of the first lady and
doesn't
the
she look amazing? I love that outfit. Mm-hmm. And it's good that they're supporting their son. He's
I like the energy of the first family. I mean, we're seeing something we've not seen
before.
That the son here was feted last week, and the first lady was on the runway. She was
it's so amazing. It's just great support for their son.
Yes, and mm-hmm.
Encouraging him to do what it is he's
into. Surprising event is even the president attended the function.
And
they didn't know. And you know, Kenyans in our usual style, guys are saying event ni saa tatu. By the time guys were getting there,
the president was there.
Yeah, so he's you know.
Wow.
You get disoriented.
You're late for something.
The Wahoo story here.
The Wahoo and Nameless.
That was a big one.
Mm-hmm.
That was quite a piece.
Wrote that they had they were divorcing.
Yes. Which is very unfortunate because, and this one created a star all over the entertainment industry, and a lot of people got to talking because most people are shocked. You know, we always associate this couple as the power couple in the entertainment industry in Kenya.
Are they the Beyonce and Jay-Z in
Kenya? They are probably the Bobby and Whitney.
Whitney?
Yeah, not in a negative way, but in an iconic way. Because
Bobby and Whitney
don't look at
that. Beyonce and Jay-Z would be...
No, I don't think we have a Beyonce and Jay-Z.
We don't have that. But basically, they are.
But in some way, if you look at the powerhouse they've created.
Let's just say they're a powerhouse in their own right.
They're a powerhouse. They're the first celebrity couple of our generation and stuff like that. And people respect them a lot because they it's a family and both of them are singing and both of them are in different businesses and they have children to raise. And this, the problem was when you bring these guys. Down the internet and you bring matters of their children. One of them is quite very young and talk about stuff that is in court that you cannot substantiate. End of the day, it really break many hearts, and that's why Kenyans were really up, is not something we need
to everybody grab yourself a copy of the Standard, and then the Pulse is inside there.
Many stories
you haven't looked at. We don't want to tell you all of it. You need to have a reason to read the paper. But before we go to DJ Genius, another story. Njoki Shege has been trending all week.
Yes.
And this is because of an article she penned down.
Yes.
Did you read it? What are your thoughts?
Njoki is a good friend, by the way.
The thing is, I know her, and she's just so humble and sweet-looking and everything. Yeah. To imagine that she would pen down such a thing, you're like, woohoo, you know? Yeah. But interesting.
She was supposed to be down the show. We met during the an award ceremony on Wednesday at Pan Africa. And she was looking all that.
What are some of the things that she said that stood out? Let's talk about the
talking
article.
About the cars and who you'd be hanging out.
Yeah,
and that she'd never date a guy who his idea of having fun.
Yeah, is going to Masaku Seven.
Which really
touched men in the wrong way.
And the guys who drive the blue
Subarus and stuff like that, which they keep talking the whole which you'll never get.
And the South B men as well, I think, featured.
I'm a South B man. Joking is offended. My friend and stuff. But no, I was never offended. Yeah. Because I think she's just speaking for this lady who thinks like that. Mm-hmm. And I think that lady has her space.
Mm-hmm.
And she's just expressing her own thoughts and ideas towards men or about men. From this lady's point of view, and I think she has a right to be heard.
I applaud her for just the guts to, you know, say what many would not want to say. And you always in society need one person who can say what most people won't say.
Yeah,
because people who think that they just never have.
Sometimes
the courage
I subscribe to
say
what she says. Sometimes I'm not really interested, but maybe she just needs a West African, then she can.
I think you're personalizing the issue.
She's just talking.
So, to be frank, and that's why we go wrong. The more Njoki talks about the truth or our mind about the men, blah blah blah. The more men are getting attracted to even read her and even know her in person,
and you want more of her to read.
On Wednesday, and guys are like, oh, she's the one. Yeah, let me say her and grab her card and something like that.
And finally, one other story breaking the internet: Kim Kardashian has gone nude again.
Yes, you've seen
the pictures.
I saw those pictures.
So do you know that she's not been paid for that?
They even went on a newspaper headline page.
Doing a magazine.
Yeah.
In the front of a magazine.
She's been paid for that.
They definitely been
she's
paid.
Not been paid. No, she's not.
She's not been paid.
For
she's
being
not
nude. Paid.
But anyway, I think it's okay. We've seen her nude before.
No, that was extreme, bro. That was everything.
That was bearing it all. But the question in the debate that was raised online was this, that she as a woman, because for money then you'd oh, she's just doing it for money. She's not being paid. That's important to know.
Yes.
But that usually people will objectify a woman for all these things she has and she's got. But when she decides to take that power into her own hands and do it, like what she did, go and post nude and do all these things, why then does she become this devil that everybody will bash and criticize?
Mm-hmm.
While on the other hand, they do it anyway.
Yes, that's true. That's why I think she's just bold and...
I am not saying it is right.
Celebrities coming out, making money out of every little inch of the body they are known.
That's the thing, she's not making money off of this one. It's a thing she just chose to do for whatever the campaign she was doing.
Hmm. But bringing it back home, how did it reflect?
Yeah, they're just...
Like you do that for charity. You go nude for charity.
Oh, no.
I did this to make money for...
They're not on the same page. Don't say that. Guys.